They would then begin to have whoever the high priest was would come with a picture.
All right.
He would get the picture, and the Bible says that he would draw water from the river Siloam. When he would draw water from the river Siloam, he would begin to bring the water back through the people. Watch this, because the people were thirsty. Woo. And as the water would begin to be brought through, the water was symbolic of something. The water meant something. The water wasn't just something that would come through. And if water dropped out of the picture, folk would jump to the ground to keep the water from hitting the ground. Look at your neighbor and ask him, how thirsty are you for this word? How? Baby, I don't know how thirsty you really are. I would really have liked to see if it was going to rain this morning, because I was going to see who was really thirsty for the word. I said last night that you're too old to be missing church because it rained. When you really thirsty, I don't care if it's a tornado warning or a hurricane. You understand that the only place safe for me is in the presence of the Lord. Look at your neighbor and tell him, I'm thirsty. Bible declares that every pair of pants for the water, so my soul longs after you. God, I just want some more of you. Let me get back in here.
Thank you, Lord.
It is as the high priest would walk through the people with the pitcher of water, the people, watch this, will begin to declare the word of the Lord. They will begin to declare, they will say, with joy shall ye draw water out of the wells of salvation.
My God.
And then the high priest would finally get to the altar. This is the first time that we see this happen and understand that it's the first time when they don't put blood on the altar.
All right.
Well, the first time. We see now where blood is not placed on the altar, where blood is not placed anywhere else, but instead is water. I believe Jesus was trying to show us that there was a transition, that after remission of sin, you got to be filled with something. Because if the water is truly what it is, then that means that the water represents a spirit. Because it is fluid. I don't care how you try to trap water, eventually, water always finds a crack.
Amen.
Y'all miss that. You put water in something long enough, water will find its way. It is fluid. Tell your neighbor, I just need a crack to get through. All I need is to be able to get to the interview. I don't need a whole lot of other stuff. You ain't got to get me the job. I just need a crack. Because if I get in there, the glory of the Lord. That's why you got to start anointing your resume before you send it off. Declare the glory is on my resume. I don't care how many doctors, how many professors, I don't care how many scientists have applied for this job. God, I lay my hands and your glory is on my resume. So that as soon as it hits the desk, it is illuminated and shines above every other resume. God, this is the last year that I get overlooked because I am disqualified. But I declare over my resume right now that God, whatever I want, I can get it because it is the word of the Lord.
God.
The high priest would pass through. When he would reach the altar, he would pour out the water on the altar. And when he would pour out the water on the altar, the people would together say in unison, "Say now, I beseech thee, O Lord. O Lord, I beseech thee. Send now prosperity."
All right.
In the midst of them saying all of that, Jesus interrupts a flow. God, did Jesus ever interrupt with your flow?
Yeah.
The Bible says in verse 37 that Jesus, first of all, he stood. Wait a minute. What you doing? Because teachers don't stand in the synagogue to teach.
All right.
They sit.
All right.
Can I tell you that Jesus is getting ready to stand up in your life when there are times when you thought that he was sitting down on some things? There's some stuff that God's getting ready to bring up that folk out, that folk think should not be coming up for you at this time. Tell your neighbor he's getting ready to stand up in you. I see it. I see it. Put on your eagle eyes and tell him, I see something getting ready to stand up in you. First thing he does, princess, is he stands. That is crazy because you don't stand. It is, as a matter of fact, it is not pulpit etiquette for you to stand when you are teaching. Second thing he does is the Bible says he cries out. Do all that loud hollering up in here in the sun, God. Is there anybody in here? And I said, I'm just looking for the big mouth one. Looking for the one that ain't interested in looking cute and ain't interested in what somebody's saying about them and ain't interested in what somebody thinks. Baby, if I could go and grab Gideon, I believe Gideon would let you know all I need is 300 lepers. I don't need everybody. I just need some folk that'll get by the pool. It's just different. They don't need a scooper. They don't need a cup. They just need their dirty hands and will declare that before the water get in my mouth, God will purify you. I had about 8 folk in here that understood God's getting ready to do something for me. Tell somebody you might not like it, but God's getting ready to do something for me. Tell them. But tell them if you do like it, I dare you to give God praise with me right now. Give them.